Oh yeah, it's all coming together. There's a video. Y'all want to watch something about something about Logan Paul, how he like scammed a bunch of people? Y'all down to watch some of that with me? Or if anyone else has suggestions, let me know. Right, right, right. Down, left, left. It's a part two to this now, just uploaded today. Investigating Logan Paul's biggest scam.
Separate investigations. CryptoZoo.co. I am so excited about this project. It's so fun. It's a really fun game that makes you money.
A fun game that earns you money. How much did you guys make in CryptoZoo?
I lost around $50,000 in crypto.
I lost $40,000.
I lost around $50,000.
$500,000 Australian, which is half a million in crypto.
Shut up! No, you haven't!
Yeah, 500K.
Today we're investigating Logan Paul's Crypto, a blockchain game that made millions, but you never worked. Some of you guys think,
and I thought Hustlers University was Hustlers. Hustlers University is just a Discord server.
And of course, at the center of it, we have Logan Paul himself, who has abandoned this thing, leaving thousands of fake orphans in his wake. Wait a second. Thousands of victims in his wake. Now, you'll be hearing from some of those people because their stories are heartbreaking. This is the first in a three-part series that's been a year in the making. And if you like high-effort investigations like this one, please consider supporting...
High-effort investigations.
Sponsors. We are viewer-supported, so if you want to and are able to, thank you. Either way, enjoy the game.
For the last 6 months, I've been working on my own NFT project. We have a massive team behind it and are probably out of pocket like a million. Just because we believe it's going to work. September 1st, CryptoZoo.co.
We don't scam. That's I've fine. Never scammed anyone before. Logan cares extremely deeply about his audience, loves his audience, loves his brand.
HHH is terrible, man. I used to really like HHH.
To make money.
Welcome to part one, the million-dollar mystery that began this whole story. Like many people, I first heard about CryptoZoo from a podcast Logan runs called Impulsive, which was the experience of a lot of people that I spoke to.
So I first heard about it on the Logan Paul podcast.
Impulsive, I think.
It was off the one of the Impulsive episodes.
The thing I'm most excited for, and this is the first time I've ever said anything about this, for the last 6 months, I've been working on my own NFT project. I think there needs to be a fresh take, and this project that I have is that fresh take.
Now look, at first, I was just as surprised at this pitch as anyone else because I just got finished roasting Logan for a different coin called Dink Doink, which his fans lost money on.
Dink Doink. I've never heard of this.
It's comedic. It's fun. It's comedy.
Now look, I know Logan and his friends tried to make it look like Dink Doink was all about memes, but it turns out they secretly were tied to the project, and Logan created the Dink Doink character himself and subsequently abandoned that project. So if you invested in it, you got blasted. And Logan rightfully took a lot of heat for Dinkle, which is why I was surprised when he seemingly immediately jumped into another crypto project. But Logan insisted CryptoZoo, it was different. It wasn't his friend's project this time, it was his. And it wasn't even a project at all. It was a game that could...
Not sure I'd be able to believe a guy who wears glasses, not only indoors, but at night.
Again, you keep using a word like game.
Yeah, that's a red flag. Wearing glasses at night. Only time I wear glasses at night is at a festival.
It's a really fun game that makes you money.
There's like so many lights blasting, like lasers being shot at EDM festivals.
This is how it was supposed to work. You started buying this crypto token.
That's good. That's good.
And you use zoo coins to then buy egg NFTs, which you can then hatch to become animals. You then can breed those two animals to become hybrid animals. For example, if you breed a gorilla and a kitten, you get a gore kitten. And the more rare the NFT, the higher the daily yield of zoo tokens.
Oh, NFT. I know immediately it's a fucking scam. Unless he's hunting vampires, exactly. Like Blade. Hunting children in traffic. Shh. Don't know. Don't tell.
Might notice some triangular qualities to this game.
Personality that I actually trusted, that I actually kind of believed in.
Obviously, when someone so influential releases something, everyone wants to be a part of it.
I still believe.
Yeah, I wouldn't show my face either. I'd be so embarrassed if I bought into that.
I thought it was a safe place having a guy like that identified, like Logan Paul being the head of the project.
They had seen this story he had been telling everyone. That he was this reformed influencer, right? That he was no longer a reckless clout goblin just in it for the money. They thought this time was different. Logan Paul couldn't possibly scam us, right? But as the game got closer to release, the CryptoZoo team started
to look terrible.
The first ever photos of these animals. And trying to find out this handmade art story wasn't really true. It was actually Adobe stock photos mashed together. Sort of first red flag of his project. And I made a video about it at the time, but it was kind of surface level and
art.
Add up beneath the surface. Something where I just couldn't shut this case down in my head. It was actually part of the announcement video that they, something they said. See if you can spot it.
We have a massive team behind it and are probably out of pocket like a million just because we believe it's going to work. Yeah.
That's the line that started this whole mystery. We spent $1 million on development. I couldn't get this out of my head. No, is he lying? There's no way he expects people to believe he spent it on art. So wait, maybe he spent it on blockchain stuff, right? That's what I thought. But then I audited the smart contract, and it's not handmade at all. It's not even original. It's what's called a fork, a copy of, you know, some other code that exists out there. One of them is called Floki Shib X, which launched before it. So where did this $1 million go? I didn't understand. And Logan just kept repeating this claim.
We put hundreds of thousands of dollars in it, personally, the whole team, a million plus.
Now, at the time I'm looking into this, there's a teaser going around for Hatch Day, which is the day you can hatch your egg NFTs. And it kind of symbolized the true launch of crypto. So I thought, maybe this is it. Maybe this is where they spent all the money on their game. Even their community manager, Ben Roth, promised people, after Hatch Day, things will take a turn.
Did any, does anyone, you guys in the chat, did you hear about this? I never heard of this. It happened.
And finally, on November 3rd, 2021, Ben Roth turned out to be right. Things did take a turn at Hatch Day, only for the worse. Let's meet one of the victims, Helicopter Bob, to explain.
My name is Rob, Helicopter Bob, lost just under $7,000.
And the first thing I asked Bob was about his animals. If he was making money with cryptos, how much he made, and if the passive yield worked.
Oh, it never did from the beginning. There, it wasn't even written into the contract where it showed that you could, that you were actually yielding the yield, but there was nothing that was actually, you know, backing that up. There was no way to claim your yield. There never was.
Wait. Play that again. Did you hear that?
There was no way to claim your yield. There never was.
Hold on. The core mechanic of crypto that you can make money with these stupid animals didn't even work on launch day, and still, to this day, a year later, still does not work, is what the investors are saying. Which, this is just crazy. People spent millions of dollars on these eggs. But it even gets worse, because I kept talking to people and I discovered something. Because remember I told you, you could buy eggs with those zoo coins? Well, apparently they also made it so you could buy them with Ethereum. And on the day of selling, about half of these purchases took place with Ethereum. Only it turns out for the people who spent ETH, not only did the yield part of it not work, did the NFTs not pay you, you also couldn't even hatch them.
So I acquired a bunch of eggs, and I actually want to play the game. I didn't acquire the eggs with the intent of keeping them. I actually wanted to
He's hunting.
Catch them and see what I got out of them and play them.
On Cold War? Oh, okay. I'm not going to watch this whole thing. I just finished the food, so I'm going to put it up. Wash my hands. I'll jump on. I had some ground beef with little potatoes and bratwurst on a piece of bread. It was good.
Basically nothing worked, and a year later, that's still true. Now, after this was discovered, the price of Zoo fell 63% in just 4 hours.
Yikes.
At this point, Logan Paul basically goes silent on crypto. No more podcasts.
Potatoes were good, dude.
Handmade art. CryptoZoo already got millions in investments, but Logan only speaks in the Discord twice over the next year. Today, sober, currently shaking my head, and yo. That was his contribution.
Yo.
Meanwhile, his community manager, Ben Roth, was actively claiming that Logan was going to be marketing CryptoZoo any day now. He told people things like, Logan is an uncontrollable marketing guru. It's over when we launch. And when we have a product to market, it'll get marketed. And marketing will crush, I promise you. And this disconnect between Logan abandoning the project and his team on CryptoZoo saying that it was going to be any day now, left investors feeling like they were being led on.
All we had to do was go on and tell us, look, there's something going on with this project, I'm abandoning it, or whatever, before people got more and more trapped. And promising, yeah, this is going to be great, but when it came to actually doing anything,
what a surprise.
Up to the people that invested initially and invested along the way on all of the fake and false promises and all of the false.
Alright, BRB, put this up. Yeah. I appreciate the patience, everyone. Through this difficult time. Just kidding. Delicious time. It's more like it, though. Let's play some fucking Cold War.